The usual areas of dispute in relation to children are with whom they should live and how often or if they should have contact with the other parent. These are issues that parents are generally encouraged to try and resolve if they can between them. It is always better for parents to sort out these type of arrangements for the benefit of the children. In the event they are unable to do so, there are manners in which to have these regulated by the courts. The other types of issues which may arise are in relation to what are called specific issues. There are a number of things that can be in dispute between parents, such as whether they should undergo a particular medical treatment or medical treatment at all, which school they should attend, whether they should be allowed to go on holiday out with the UK, which religion or belief system a child should follow, or the name of a child. But generally, specific issues can be used to regulate any issue in dispute. The other more prevalent areas are in relation to child protection issues. And by that, I'm talking about when one parent takes a child or attempts to take a child out with a jurisdiction. And you can obtain a court order to stop someone doing that, or in the event it has happened, to have the child delivered back to the jurisdiction where they had been residing. A court order is not always necessary, and in fact should only happen if a dispute is incapable of being resolved by some other means. In Scotland, the matter has to be considered as to what is in the best interests of the child. Many families or parents are able to make arrangements between themselves, and that is always better for a child if their parents are able to sort out what should be happening in relation to their care. If they are unable to do so themselves, they can seek assistance from solicitors or other alternative dispute resolution options, such as mediation, collaboration, family therapy, or arbitration. In the event that a court action is required, it is not always the case that a court order is actually granted. There is a non-intervention principle, which means a court order should only be granted if it is better for the child that a court order is granted than not. There generally isn't a typical arrangement in relation to child care arrangements. Every child and every family is different. What has to be considered is what is in that particular child's best interest and what their welfare dictates. There can, however, be certain arrangements that might be considered more usual or popular, such as alternating weekends, midweek contact, a shared care arrangement, including a 50-50 shared care arrangement, holiday contact, and sharing special days or special occasions. What is important in relation to arrangements for children is that the children have a routine so that they have clarity and security as to what is happening. It is also important, if the parents are able to agree arrangements, that those have been capable of happening, as that is important to a child to avoid stress and anxiety. A mother's rights are not more favoured by the courts. The father's rights are equally as important. Parental rights and responsibilities for both parents are equal and equivalent. A child should have a relationship with both parents, and that is the presumption, unless there is a very good reason for a child not having a relationship with one parent. A child's views is a mandatory consideration in Scotland. In every case where there's a dispute between the parents, in regard to what should happen in regard to a child. A child needs to be given an opportunity of saying whether they want to express a view. If they want to express a view, there are a number of ways that that can be obtained. In every case, the manner in which a child should express their view is explored, and there are a number of ways of doing that. They require to complete a form, which can be sent to them. A child can also speak to a child welfare reporter or directly to a sheriff. The weight to be attached to the views of a child will depend on their age and maturity. And it is also a consideration as to whether those are the child's own genuinely held views. If you need any assistance or guidance, you should seek early legal advice. There are a number of options that don't necessarily involve court, and there are alternative dispute resolution options. If you have any queries or need any input or guidance in relation to a child-related matter, you should not hesitate to contact Waitmans or our family law teams, who can offer invaluable advice to help you and guide you through which is a difficult and stressful matter.